already know this is Punch Drunk Boxing, a.k.a. Mr. Moonshine himself. Ladies and gentlemen, oh boy, Golden Boy Promotions, man, they upsetting everybody. They are on fire. I mean on fire, folks. They upsetting everybody. These are the party crashes of boxing. Golden Boy Promotions are doing it again. Bob Arum is like, oh my God, put the fire out. Give me the fire extinguisher. Timothy Bradley, help me out here. Help me out here. Andre, where are you? Oh my God. Don't let the judges say the scorecard. Put the fire out. Oh my God. Oh Lord. Oh Lord. Oh my God. Yo, I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, I am telling you, Golden Boy Promotions is upsetting everybody. You don't want Bob Arum to get a heart attack now. Oh my God. I should have never put up these fights too early, damn it. Blame it on the coronavirus. Blame it on him. Help me out here. Help me, Timothy. Timothy, hold my hand. Come on. I've had it with these upsets. Oh, my God. Shout out to Julio Franco. Again, shout out to JoJo Diaz. Shout out to Patrick Teixeira. Yo, they are upsetting everybody. Everybody. You already know they wanted Carlos Adamas to win that fight. You know that. You know they wanted Maloney to win that fight. You know that they're in the zone. In the zone. You know y'all wanted Tevin Farmer to win that fight. Damn it, mate. Damn it, Farmer. Damn it. We should have gone another route. I thought JoJo Diaz was done. Damn it, Oscar De La Hoya. You know better than us. You little sneaky bastard. Now, of course, let me fix this camera up a little bit. All right. So, y'all already know that Golden Boy Promotion have been having a little bit of drama. And some of the drama been, you know, overshadowing the other good things that's happening to Golden Boy Promotions. A lot of people got all these critique about Golden Boy Promotions. And they want to critique about, oh my God, oh yeah, I got a Canelo Alvarez. But you know what? They got champions. And they got futures of boxing. And they still got Virgil Ortiz. They're going to be fighting July 24th, baby. He's going to be the one with the prestige 147. Probably 147 pounder king in the future to come in the sport of boxing. We can't wait to see that fight. We got to give it to JoJo Diaz, my fighter rematch with Tevin Farmer. I think he should just keep on going further. Get another opponent. Keep on going up. Try to get a unification bout. Keep on going up, baby. Also, again, Patrick Teixeira. Yo, I'm gonna tell you, Golden Boy Promotions is doing a lot of good things. Set aside Canelo Alvarez. We already know Canelo Alvarez. We already know that Golden Boy Promotion got their cash cow, not only in their umbrella, but the cash cow of boxing. I'm liking what Golden Boy Promotion is doing, whatever they're doing right. And you know what I like about Golden Boy Promotions is that they are actually putting their fighters at, you know, to challenge themselves. It's almost like, man, you know what? I'm going to give you these hard fights if I want to further invest in you. I'm just ain't gonna put you out there and just be spending my marketing money on y'all. And I gotta see what I really got. I really wanna see the grit that y'all have. I wanna see the dedication and the focus that y'all have. And I'm gonna put you up to the test. I wanna make y'all champion, but y'all gotta put in the work. You know it's Oscar De La Hoya. You know ain't nothing gonna come easy with Oscar De La Hoya. Oscar De La Hoya fought everybody. Bruno Hopkins, everybody. These are Hall of Famers. In the end of the day, they know what they're watching. They know what they have. And they know what they gotta do to put these opponents in front of them and see what comes out of it. Yo, Golden Boy Promotions is doing a great job. And aside from the Ryan Garcia issue, because of course that's taking a lot of you know, attention away from what they're doing good. Look, Ryan Garcia is a young prospect, could be contending, could be one of the forefronts of the sport of boxing, one of those fighters that's projected to be one of the forefronts of the sport of boxing to uplift the sport of boxing. Of course, there's a lot of drama going on with these dudes. It is a constant drama. It's a constant that we're hearing from one side. It's like a relationship. It's like a family. It's a family feud all the goddamn time. I want to see Ryan Garcia happy. I want to see Oscar De La Hoya being happy because, of course, Ryan Garcia is projected to be the next Golden Boy. The next Golden Boy. So, of course, there's a lot of things that's going on with Ryan Garcia. Reports saying that he's turning down fights. And of course, the boxing fans are frustrated. I'm frustrated. You know, we're frustrated because we see that this kid could be a lot. He could be a lot more than what he may think he is. You understand what I'm trying to say? We want him to pursue his greatness. We want all young fighters going out there, pursue your greatness. Forget about the purse. The purse will come once you accomplish it, these great things. Remember who's on your side. You got the guy that has the blueprint. In the blueprint and exceeding and excelling in the ring and also outside the ring. He has mastered the art inside the ring and outside the ring. These guys and Golden Boy Promotions, Oscar De La Hoya, Bernard Hopkins, the Matchmaker, Gomez, all these guys are doing great, great. Trust in them. Trust in them. They're going to take you to the promised land because they've been in the promised land on both sides. So, yo, let me know what y'all want next from Julio Franco. That's a great win. Great win. And we got to shout out Trainer, man. Trainer of the year already. Maybe. I'm saying like this. That's a gym full of champions. Champs for the fighters of the future. Garcia, man. The Garcia Lab. Man, they got a lot of things cooking up in there. So shout out to Garcia. Shout out to everybody, man. God bless each and every one of y'all. Leave your comment in the comment box. Let me know what you think about the fight with the Maloney and Franco. Of course, I thought they was going to rob them. And also, ESPN, come on, you got to stop with the bias. Just call it straight how it is. Tim Bradley, call it straight. Everybody in the commentary booth, if this is a sport that anything could happen, then you know what? Commentate the fight that way. Be fair. The other man is risking his life as well, just like the other man, okay? Man, just call it straight down the middle. Stop with this biased commentary stuff and expecting somebody to win because we can't contradict ourselves in the sport of boxing. If this is a sport of boxing that we don't know what's going to happen or anything can happen, like I said, commentate it that way. Y'all already know, man. Go fight, though, Babaloney. He's going to come right back. You already know. We want to see a rematch. That might happen. I can't wait to see it. I love boxing. Boxing is back. Shout out to everybody. Y'all positive vibe. I love y'all. Peace out. God bless. And on to the next Golden Boy Promotions 2020.